Using JPA and Hibernate, you can choose between various ways to query your data, and each of them supports one or more kinds of projections. That provides you with lots of options to implement your persistence layer. But which one fits your use case? And which one should you avoid if you want to optimize your persistence layer for performance? To answer these questions, we need to talk about the different ways to define a query. One of them is JPQL, of course. It's a query language based on your domain model. But you can also use multiple proprietary and standardized APIs to create a query. Or you can execute native SQL queries if you need to use database-specific query features or define very complex queries. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new tutorial video. Today I will explain when you should use which approach to create the optimal query and projection for your use case. But before we proceed, if you're new here and want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate, and all types of other Java persistence-related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. And if you have any topic or question related to Hibernate that you want to learn more about, please share it in the comment section below. Okay, now let's get back to our topic. Picking the right approach to define your query is not the only thing you need to do to use JPA in Hibernate efficiently. You also need to choose the optimal projection for your use case. JPA and Hibernate enable you to select entities, DTOs, and Scalar values. In the following minutes, I will explain the differences between these kind of projections, when to use which one, and how to define a query that returns it. For most teams, entity projections are the most commonly used ones. But that's often not the best approach. Entities might be easy to use and are the best fit for all write operations. But as I showed in a previous article, which you will find in the description, selecting and managing an entity creates an overhead that slows down your application. So if you need to optimize your persistence layer for performance, you should only use entity projections if you need them to implement write operations. In these situations, the persistence provider generates SQL insert, update, and delete statements based on the entity lifecycle state transitions. That makes the implementation of your use cases much easier and is worth the overhead. For all other use cases, you should prefer Scalar or DTO projections. After you decided to use an entity projection, you need to choose how to define the query. With entity projections, you have full flexibility. All options to define queries with JPA and Hibernate support entity projections. You could, of course, implement your own query to fetch one or more entities by their primary key. But you don't have to. There are more comfortable options available. If you have ever used JPA or Hibernate, you know the find method on the Entity Manager interface. It provides an easy-to-use way to load one entity by its primary key. On top of this, Hibernate provides an API that enables you to load more than one entity by its primary key. You just need to provide a list of IDs and Hibernate loads all of them in one query. If you can statically define a not too complex query and need to filter by non-primary key attributes in your where condition, you should use a named JPQL query. JPQL is a query language similar to SQL. The main two differences are that you can define your query based on your domain model, and that JPQL is not as feature-rich as SQL. You can define named JPQL queries by annotating an entity class with one or more named query annotations. Since Hibernate 5 and JPA 2.2, you no longer need to wrap multiple named query annotations in a named queries annotation. The syntax of a JPQL query is pretty similar to SQL. The query in the following code snippet selects all author entities with a given first name. You can instantiate this query by calling the createNameQuery method of your entity manager with the name of the query. This method returns a query or type query interface. You can then use this interface to set bind parameter values and to execute the query. JPA's criteria API enables you to create your query dynamically at runtime. The required code is not as easy to read as a JPQL query, and executing the query takes a little bit longer. So you should only use it if you need to adjust your query based on user input dynamically. But as hard as the criteria API might be to read, it's still much better than creating a JPQL query by concatenating strings. So please, if you need to adjust your query based on user input, use the criteria API. Here you can see an example that selects all author entities with a given first name. This is the same query as I showed you in the previous JPQL example. As you can see, the code block that uses the criteria API is longer and harder to read. To create a criteria query, you first need to get a criteria builder from the entity manager and create a query that returns the entity class. You can then use this query to define the from and where clause. After you've created the criteria query, you can use it to create a type query, set the bind parameter values, and execute it. The criteria API supports the same features as JPQL. Explaining all of them in details would take too long for this video. If you want to learn more about it, please join my Advanced Hibernate online training. If your query gets really complex, or if you want to use database-specific features, you need to use a native SQL query. Hibernate takes the native query statement and sends it to the database without parsing it. I have a separate video on this, and you will find a link to it in the description. Within your query, you can do whatever your database supports. You're not limited to the features that Hibernate or any other JPA implementation support. This is important because the feature set of JPQL is pretty limited. So native SQL queries are often your only option to implement complex query use cases. If your native query returns all columns mapped by your entity, and if their names are identical to the ones used in the entity mapping, you just need to provide your entity class as the second parameter to the create native query method. Hibernate will then apply the standard entity mapping to your query result. You can customize this mapping using an SQL result set mapping annotation. I explained this annotation and how you can use it to define all kinds of mappings in a series of articles on my blog. You will find them below. Scalar value projections are my least favorite ones. In almost all situations, I prefer DTO projections, which I will show you in the following sections. Scalar value projections can be a good option if you need to read and immediately process 1 to 5 database columns for which you don't have a matching DTO projection. The main downside of Scalar value projections is that they are very uncomfortable to use. You can use this projection with a JPQL, criteria, or native SQL query. In all three cases, your query returns an object array. When you use this array, you need to remember the position of each column and cast the array element to the correct type. Here's an example of a JPQL query that uses the Scalar value projection. If you want to learn how to use it with a criteria query or a native SQL query, please take a look at my articles, How to Select Multiple Scalar Values in a Criteria Query and Complex Result Set Mappings. I link both of them below. From a performance point of view, DTO projections are almost as good as Scalar value projections. They provide the best performance for read operations, but the strong typing and the descriptive attribute names make this projection so much easier to use. You can use DTO projections in JPQL, criteria, and native SQL queries. The definition of a JPQL query that uses a DTO projection is pretty simple. You define a constructor call in your select clause using the keyword new, followed by the fully qualified name of your DTO class and a list of parameters. JPA's criteria API enables you to create your query dynamically at runtime. As I explained earlier, this is a little bit slower than using a JPQL query and the code is hard to read. So better use a JPQL query if you can define your query statically. You define and execute the criteria query in almost the same way as the criteria query I showed you earlier. The only difference is that you now need to call the construct method on the criteria builder to define the constructor call. If your query is too complex for JPQL, you can use a native SQL query and an SQL result set mapping using a constructor result annotation. Hibernate then executes the native query and iterates through the result set. For each record, it calls the constructor defined by the constructor result annotation. Here you can see the definition of a constructor call of the book value class. Hibernate will provide the value of the title column as the first, and the value of the date column as the second parameter. To use this SQL result set mapping with your query, you need to provide its name as the second parameter to the create native query method. When using JPA and Hibernate, you can choose between various ways to read the required information. You can use JPQL queries if they are static and not too complex. The Criteria API enables you to define your query dynamically using a Java API. And if you need to use the full feature set of your database, you need to use a native SQL query. You should use entity projections only if you need to implement write operations. JPA and Hibernate provide APIs to load one or more entities by their primary key. You can also use entity projections with JPQL, Criteria, and native queries. Scalar value projections are not very comfortable to use, and you should better use a DTO projection. DTO projections are the best option for read-only operations. They are strongly typed, easy to use, and provide the best performance. You can use them with JPQL, Criteria, and native queries.